Hey guys, Dark Prometheus here, and my experiment with the two-piece D is done, so that's another issue to deal with altogether. But here we go. Shouldn't have too many issues with doing this on one computer. This game, at least. Other games, maybe. Take all. Okay, I know. This is better. That's why he beat my ass so handedly. I know his armor is better because it has Masterwork Enlightened. That's why he beat my ass more. And his buckler was better, and that's why I wasn't blocking shit. Centurion's cape, I have a noble's cape, so. So, look at Sohab over here. It's like he has seen men killed in front of him before. Follow me. You will return to the city. Well done, guys. I assume that Sohab was heading for the old ruins. The Illyrians have set up a camp there a while ago. It looks like they did find something worth looking at. So now what? Now Master Sohab will enjoy the hospitality of our torture chambers. They aren't as sophisticated as Gilius' dungeons, but I'm sure they'll get the job done. Let me talk to him first. If you can trust what he'll tell you. Yeah. I mean, I saved him, otherwise, he's gonna die. Oh, Lore Master. It's over again, frustrated that nobody hit the grass, a simple fact, and let him go. I'm not interested in the affairs of man. I'm interested in machines. Can't you explain it to him? It's more complicated. What are you gonna fix? An ore smelter. The descriptions can't be trusted. As you can see, there is no cause for alarm here. Both know Gilius wouldn't waste his men on an ore smelter. There has to be more to it. Then you know more than I do. If it's just a fancy old smelter, we'll blow it up and be done with it. If it's something more interesting, I think it's in your best interest if you're safe and sound. Alright, very well. He's all yours. You don't have to wait long. Dilia returns less than a half hour later and gives you a bloodstained scroll. He told us the mantra the moment he saw the instruments. Of course we had to. Make sure he told us the truth. Take a look. Can you handle it? I gain new insight. So I get some more skills, I get some materials. I really don't know what I'm looking at. Then kill them all and torch the camp. Why overcomplicate things? And while you're there, skulking in the wilderness, take a look at the raider's camp. What's that? Walked in and started making demands, claiming that his gang is captured a lord. We didn't take the bastard seriously and used him for target practice. It turned out that Tiberius that used this. The words in this are great. Is really missing, but it was too late. So take a look at the camp, will you? If it's something you can handle alone, by all means do it. We have too many problems as it is, and one less thing worried about. We can tell you about the mining camp. Kids are everywhere, but I don't have enough money to look under every stone. Also, really instead of camp there, start digging. They might have something there, something we don't know about. They have nothing, you're just waiting for an excuse to attack us. Where do they get supplies? Too far from Bandoran to be supplied regularly, they used to live out the land. We'll have to see. Probably the damn traitors down here. What's this piece of crap? The door is barred. To open it. How do I get in this godforsaken establishment? How do I get in this damn place? That must not be the guild. No, this is. See what this man has to say. Okay, stay and listen. Okay. Oh, he's talking about how we all need to be more pious. I ain't got time for that at the moment. That's the inn. That's Fangs. Who's this? I'm Matilda Ace, a merchant by trade. Dealing the finest weapons and armor. The Commissarium. Alright, let's go take a look. Of course! Run! Yeah, I'm not fighting that here. You silly. You mad. That's what it is. Who is this? Who knows? Let's go see the blacksmith. Price. Proper schematics. Show me your weapon schematics. Swords. Your armor. What is my I wonder what my armor is considered. 50 iron armor penalty. Okay, it's gotta be some kind of weapons reduction, okay. I think. Okay. Browse the wares. And this is what I have equipped. Right? Yes. Helms, show me those, show me your light metals, axes, hammers, spears, see your throwing, oh, so I don't have anything to repair, okay, that's cool. That's Fang. Okay, what are these guys doing? I'd like to get some plum. Plum were amazing back then. So we can get 5. And 1 net. Plum were one of the first mass weapons that actually did some real hardcore damage against people. Wait, do I have to go talk? I can just leave, right? Or do I gotta talk to him? I remember if I have to do that or if I have to talk to him. Let's see. Alright, I just go out the front door, I guess. Alright. Okay, let's go with... Stay with that. And go with 1 point. Oh, I got some general skills up too. Thank you. Throwing. I get one in throwing. I guess I'm just going around throughout the front here. So it's just me, myself, and I. Okay, see a group of weary travelers. What's going on here? What am I, a lord of the Oh, they're trying to make it on their own. Plus they bring cheap goods from the 30 Imperials per head. There are 5 of them, so that's 150. I'm a Praetor, let him in. He'll probably be able to tell me exactly what's going on outside these walls. I have a feeling something is definitely wrong. Give me everything you have. She's too eager. He has an axe. Never mind. Get out of here. Can't deal with that right now. Okay. Some orders. Play my debt. See you first. What happened to your village? Faster before, 10 years ago, we were able to fend for ourselves. If they're well defended, they have a chance for how long. Heard of a place called Inferine. Adeptly named in the old days, a word meant sacrifice offered to souls of dead heroes. They say the village is built around a pit which connects this world with the one below. Some say it leads into Tartarus itself. Or Tartus. Tartus. Yeah, it's the Greek Roman underworld. I don't know if it's true or not, but I was told the writers Inferie as if it were the plague. Also had a habit of throwing lone travelers down the pit to thank the souls before or below the protection blessings, maybe some madness keeps them safe. Hey. Whoops. The armor. A Phyrexian armor. 3. It's not as good as mine. It is masterwork. And not great, but hey, it'll sell for something. How's the wares? Alright. Now let's get out of here. Wonder if I'm supposed to pull up the map screen. Tavern, Fang, Blacksmith. So the bowmen are over here. Okay, I see. This is how you okay. Got it. Makes sense. This doesn't look intriguing by any means. All right, F5 this. Prying eyes by a tall wooden palace that circles it. Guard watches you approach from the top. Wooden guard. How do I deal with this? Wait until dark. Approach. Try to leave. Stay here to die. You know how this works. We attack, you die. Gilead uses your death so she should come and force the good plan, but you have to die to bring forth the grand finale. I don't believe you. I was promised a promotion by Gellius since a few men. You know what? Know that you don't stand a chance if Antidius orders to attack. The reinforcements are on the way. They were on their way. Now they're lying in a ditch. You're welcome to join them or walk away. Tell Gellius that you found nothing of value here. Why do you have to die for some godforsaken mine? Mulls over it. I don't want to die fighting for this mine when Gaelius comes here any more than you want to die for it when Anidius comes here. What do you say? Believe on one condition, Praetor. You tell Anidius the same thing. You find nothing of value in the mine? Gaelius will crucify us if we hand over the mine to... You have my word. No. I'm lying. I'm not going to tell him that. Come on. Really? Really? Of course I'm not gonna say that. But it's 5-on-1. I would never survive those odds. Put some leave. What about the mine? There are some machines there that appear to be intact. I must talk to you about the map. Go meet him. You spoke of destiny earlier. Says Anidius, give me the map you wrestled from the Commercium. Or Commercium. You know, of course, that our empires lasted thousands of years. Though military and diplomatic victories, we had conquered the known world. Era of peace and prosperity about to begin when the accursed Centauri came in. Taller than any human, with glowing eyes and sharp claws, it came from the depth of the underworld and attacked without warning, slaughtering men and women alike. Fought the devil's tooth and nail, but when the victory was at hand, they called forth their gods. Okay. Can you imagine a living horde towering over the battlefield and sweeping it with its arms, tearing flesh and armor with its talons? Our only chance was to reach to the higher planes and summon allies who could help us even the odds. But the call was answered, and the allies came. They burned the Quintari and their gods, leaving nothing but ashes. They saved us, but it was too late. The Empire had fallen, for too much had been destroyed. Zed and our allies, the lords of the higher planes, left us to rebuild and restore. But as you can see, we're living in our crumbling town, still fighting each other like savages. We're lords of the higher planes, or the high lords, they are most kindly referred to, answer call. Belizor, the dreamer, Hathor, the flame walker, and Thor, Agast, the artificer. I know it's artifact, but I taught our Magi much and built many wondrous machines and engines of war. According to legends, the Magi had attended a temple built by Thor, a god, and studied the arcane art there. The centuries-old accounts describe the engines of war and divine weapons in great detail. I don't know if the weapons are still there, I don't know if the temple is still there, but I believe there's a reason why another copy of the map has been found. It's with me. It's fate. The years have been sent several expeditions to find the temple and bring me the weapons of the gods. While failed one way or another, looking at you, I'm beginning to think that sending large expeditions was a mistake. Large groups attract too much attention, they are slow and suffer from the all too familiar intrigues and inner squabbles. They are vulnerable to spies and saboteurs, they cost a fortune, but one man, one resourceful man with nothing to lose. But everything to gain. I want you to find the temple for me, guys. If you do, you will be rewarded and have lived beyond your wildest dreams. If you do, we'll reshape the world and plant a seed of a new empire. We'll do away with petty squabbles over broken towns and domains. We will unite our people and give them the goals worthy of the banners that once flew over this land. That sounds like a plan. Go to Mandorin, find Domitius Ulpius. He's led one of the expeditions. He was convinced that the Magi Tyres hold the key to the map, but there's only one tower left intact, the Tower of Samadhi. The tower is sealed as our most ancient place of wonder that House Aurelians deem too dangerous. Guys would rather bury the plaques than face it. Find Demetrius. If there's a way in, he'll help you find it, or else seek elsewhere. Do you think Gaius can handle it? He showed promise. I'll wait. What am I waiting for? He gets my vote. Walk with me, guys. Alright. Follow Deller outside. We have a situation here, he says after a long pause. Best way. Commander Carinus of the Imperial Guard's fame thinks that he'll do a better job running Teron. From what I've heard about him, his advantage go a lot further, and Teron is just stepping stone on his way to bigger things. Oh! It stops tonight. Your job is to get him out in the open where the boatmen can get him. Sounds easy. Tell him that one of his men betrayed him. That's got to get his attention. But remember that fools don't become commanders of the Imperial Guards. You'll have to be very, very persuasive. If he buys it, get him into the inn after dark. The boatmen cheaters will be waiting in the room next door. Make sure they have a shot. See? Easy. And if he doesn't buy it? If he doesn't buy it, you are good as dead. If he suspects that something is wrong, you will not leave the barracks alive. Do you have on his bodyguards? Not much. They're well trained. They're loyal. Tereus watched Carinus back the longest. Decius replaced Marsilius, who died from malaria last year. He's a bit young, but he's very good. Some say he would have been a centurion by now if Carinus didn't take him as a bodyguard. It's a position of respect, but I have a feeling it's not the kind of respect the kid wants. Chatted with him once off the job. He told me to go. Best life is getting a suit. Do we have anything I can use? If anyone can help you, it's Cato, but his price is sometimes too steep, if you know what I mean. Might not be enough. Do you have any better ideas? If Sarab were still alive, we could have used him. Also, can I still check that this town? Still check this quest. Discovering a new location. Nice. I have no idea how to do it properly. Very well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here he is. Avenius. Knows your presence by getting up and loading the crossbows. There's one of the tents, that's the situation. Barks some orders, swearing at his men and saying them to take position around the camp. I'm here to negotiate. Found this fine young man walking alone in these very dangerous woods. He told us that he's a nephew of a local lord. We decided to keep him company, do our best to ensure his safety. I'm sure that his uncle would appreciate our help and reward us generously. So, I do have proof of life. He does live. But there's like 6 people in there and I can't handle that. Okay, tactics, critical strikes, or how much shields, ammunition. And my guess is let's go over to the inn and go to sleep like we normally would. Maybe that's how you would do it. Anything interesting? I still need to talk to you. Second floor near the hallway. You're funny. Of course I failed, I'm a noob. Wait. Oh, it's cool. second room on the right, which is this one. That's weird. Okay. Yes. Penetrating skull fracture and a cranial bleeding. Oh, God. That's funny. Intracranial bleeding? You'd never survive that. Out of the question, play rise with some weakness. That one. Hado. Hell's Kado. I don't even know who that is. Gotta be someone in here. Cado. Oh, he theoretically he'll probably be over by the damn guild. Probably over here, right? Looking for people is real. This guy. Find this guy. I'd just say hell with it, go for it. But he might be in one of these random houses. know what? We're gonna YOLO this. Wait, I thought this was the bear. Wait, do I have to wait for night? Yeah, let's try one of these houses. I know he's in one of them. We're set up in Fangs. No. No one is. Okay. Commenced. Could be this one. I'm just... Alright, so I'm not gonna hassle you through this. I'll find... this, next time. Later!